We did what you asked.
It's like I said. Fusar knows who you are and knows the price on your head. It's a big problem.
I see.
But if we can silence him, then I can help you escape before anyone has time to get here from America. That way, we all get what we want.
We want to get the boat you promised us.
And you will. But you have found yourself in the middle of a war, I'm afraid. Fuso has called in the Navy from Cuba. There's no way a boat could leave right now.
Hercule! Hercule, s'il vous plaît! Vite! Vite!
Come. Follow me.
Quick!
So now we have a real problem. This must be the boat he called in from Cuba.
That's a goddamn warship.
You kinda have to hand it to this feller.
So I guess great minds think alike.
So what now?
We fight all we want.
Any of you boys feel like running? So what do we do?
I will go get the cannon ready.
Okay, let's get to it.
Shoot them, man! Shoot them! Fellas on the beach!
I see.
We got more coming at us on the right!
Let's prepare the welcoming party.
Why the hell are we doing this? This ain't our fight!
Do you want to get out of here or not?
He's using us! Just shoot him,
Micah! Arthur!
Bill! Micah! Hold them back! They're cool! Get that cannon into position! I'll get the ammunition!
Because if we don't, we're gonna die here and now.
Okay, then.
Follow me? This is kind of fun.
Okay.
two of us must go and use the cannon.
You go, Arthur. I'll gladly hold them off this beach a while longer.
You sure?
Just certain, son.
My valet.
You think that cannon will be enough?
Only one way to find out.
Christ's sake, how many men has Hussar got?
That's the problem. It doesn't matter how many we kill. He will have the money to get more. More shot. Empty water line. We need to put a serious hole in that boat.
What are you doing? Try aiming at the big boat, Morgan. And again, Morgan.
Ammunition! Reloading! Look! It's taking on water! Keep firing! Let's get down from here. Come on.
Holding on.
That was quite some shooting, boys.
Thank you.
What now?
Oh, they'll be back. But I found a boat for you. And he should be arriving on the dock anytime now.
Great. Micah, go meet with the captain. If he's amenable and discreet, tell him we'll be ready to set sail soon. Bill, come help me collect poor old Javier.
Sure.
Get cool. It was a great pleasure to make your acquaintance.
I thought I was dead for sure.
Hi, boys. We got a real problem. Nice Mr. Fusar don't want us going nowhere. He knows just who we are. If he can keep us here for a few more days, well...
And what about the captain of the ship here?
They got him trussed up like a hog. Guards all over the place. Got us surrounded with gun positions, so when we try to sail out, he's gonna blow holes in us.
This fella is really beginning to try my patience.
He ain't even had you tortured yet.
I like the man's style. He's thorough, nasty, and vindictive. However... In this instance, I don't see we got any alternative, but we go and free our friendly captain and destroy the artillery.
For once, I agree with you.
Hercule?
Oh, I'll fight Alberto Fusa every day I can.
All right. Bill, you're gonna guard Javier on the ship here. Micah, Arthur, let's get to work. Hercule, we follow you.
Anale, this way.
Let's get up around the back of that artillery post. There's two guards. Arthur, come on. Get your knife ready. You take out the first guy, and I'll get the other one.
Okay.
Okay, clear.
Let's plant the explosives.
You got it secured properly, cowpoke?
I think so.
Knowing you, I have my doubts.
Shut up, Mike.
Come on, run!
You got the bombers! On the roof! Come on! There's another set of cannons up ahead!
I got you now, you bastard.
We are all bastards, my friend. But only one of us is some would-be emperor's whore.
We know who you are.
And nobody knows who you are. Not even your goddamn father.
You maggots are going to die.
eventually. I'm sure we will. But not today, and not because of you.
The U.S. Navy is on the way.
I am sure they are, which is why you're going to let us leave. Or you are dying right here, my friend.
We've killed better men than you fools. Enough.
Here!
You saved my life. Thank you, Captain.
I suppose you men are my cargo.
Dutch Vanderlyn, I am sorry you got hurt.
Captain Sam.
Let's go. Gentlemen.
Back to the ship. Come on. What happened to Fushar? He escaped?
I didn't see him.
Damn it.
Up there,
in the tower?
Yes. Yes, that's him.
This goddamn idiot. Come on!
He's shooting! We have to take him down!
Okay, let's get out of here!
Got it for you, Javier.
Captain, can you handle the ship?
I'll be fine. Come on, we'll get going with the tide before I get any more surprise interviews with local officials.
Are you gonna be okay?
We'll be like you. We'll disappear, probably. Back to Haiti. Believe me, we'll be long gone by morning.
Good. Thank you. Oh. We survived.
Just about.
What now?
What now?
What do you mean, what now?
I mean, we're headed back to Lemoyne again, and we're all wanted men.
We slip ashore one by one, find out what's what.
We don't cut and run now? Head back to Blackwater.
No.
Why not?
Because the last thing they'll be thinking is for us to turn up.
We've been on the run for a while now, and it feels like our luck has turned. You know? And I ain't turning back. I had a good run of it, I guess.
We ain't even played our hand yet. We just need to put some more money in our pockets. Make our escape. Broke, alone, they're gonna pick us off one by one, and you know it.
Maybe.
Not. Maybe. We need to split up. Keep a low profile. Try to track down the rest. But carefully. See if they send any mail. Arthur, you check Shady Bell. We'll find each other eventually. We always do.
And then what?
Then we meet up. We gather the family, we get some money, and get the hell out of there. That's the plan.
We all acting crazy. And that's not what I thought we were going to be doing
here. We have been in a bad way. Listen. I will kill for my family. Any of you want to judge me for that? That's fine. But that is who I am. Anyone disagree? Anyone?
Oh, you're an asshole. What a dick. You're lucky I need you right now, because if I didn't, I would throw dynamite at your stupid fucking ass. Or maybe perhaps a Molotov. It's a hard decision. Well, what would you guys do? Would you blow them up or would you let them burn? I don't know. I'm thinking maybe I should let them burn.
Crash of words. May I
whisper, but no tongue can tell. He who drinks from the deep water, may he know the depths of the well. May I stand unshaken amidst the crash of the world. May I stand unshaken amidst the crash of the world. Oh, traveler, what have you seen? Where the crossroads, where you've been, where you've been? I once was standing tall, now I feel my back's against the wall. Stand unshaken. Amidst the crash of the world, may I stand unshaken. Amidst the crash of the world. But I could not see, and I don't wonder, as a wayward son, was a hunter be haunted by the smoking gun? Oh, stand unshaken, amidst the crash of a world.
Anybody here? Hello? Anyone here? Susan! Strauss, you here?
Dear Uncle Tacitus, I do so hope you enjoyed your vacation. Lucky you, leaving like that. And you always suggested you were too old for travel. I hope you and your cousins enjoyed yourselves. Me and your grandnieces have decided to take a trip of our own, as the place has become so dreary and godforsaken in your absence. We've gone to visit relatives. From my daddy's side, you are not yet acquainted with them, in Lacay, a small village just north of Saint Denis. It's buggy and muggy, but apparently neither is too bad at this time of year. Please come see us when you can. Yours sincerely, Caroline.
Well, thank you, darling niece Caroline. I guess I'm coming to see you in LeCay.
Milton keeps sending us back every day to search this place.
There quite clearly isn't a gang of outlaws held up here.
Someone is here. Look, those are fresh footprints. Looks like someone might be here right now.
Sure, someone is here. There's always someone everywhere.
Well, let's look around, then. See if we can find something for Mr. Milton.
Mr. Milton? I'd like to find a poisonous snake for him.
That's enough, Mr. Johns. You take Mr. Bunter and search around back.
Mr. Worley, let's head inside. Gentlemen, be careful.
You'll be all right.
Yep.
Thank you.
Come on. Arthur! Arthur's here!
Oh, Arthur! Oh, you're alive.
Just about.
Come inside. Come on, it's raining. Hey, everybody, look who's here.
How y'all doing? Hey, old man, wake up.
Hey, Arthur, they got John.
Good to see you.
Yeah, he got arrested.
He ain't hung yet?
Not yet. They moved him to Sisica. He's been working on a chain gang.
Howdy.
Oh, look at this.
Yes, they got John.
Okay, okay.
Hey!
How'd you folks find each other? What happened? Can somebody get me a cup of coffee or something?
It was Mrs. Adler who saved us, Dutch. After the robbery in Saint-Denis, she got us away from the camp before the Pinkertons turned up. Then Mrs. Adler and Mr. Smith drove away the degenerates of her living here.
Mrs. Adler, we owe you.
Yes.
Yes. Yes.
Thank you.
It's been real hard, Dutch. We've been surviving, but only just. What we gonna do?
Things have been tough. There ain't no doubt about that. Trust me. I am gonna get us out of here. This ain't over.
Ain't none of you folks interested in our adventures?
Guess we're more interested in escaping the hangman on our tail?
Cheerful nymph of the prairie, wasn't you, Abigail?
Oh, sure. My fair heart jumps for joy when I set eyes on you, Micah.
We buried Hosea, Dutch. Charles and I stole his body from the law one night and gave him a proper burial. It was real nice.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
Well, here you is. Well, I asked everyone I could find, and eventually someone knew, said you fools were out here. Shit. Give me a drink or something.
Get your own damn drink.
In our absence, Mrs. Adler here has been looking after things. Now sit down.
This is Agent Milton with the Pinkerton Detective Agency.
Already?
On behalf of Cornwall Kerosene and Tar, the United States government, and the Commonwealth of West Elizabeth.
Here we go.
We are here to arrest you. Come out with your hands up.
Give them to a count of five, then give them everything. Actually,
let them have it.
Everyone get down!
Ask him!
Arthur, follow me!
Fine,
this
you
is
been.
Real bad.
Just stay down, Ollie.
Where are we going?
This way. There's a trap door into the other house. We can try to flank them. Okay, let's go!
Oh! saved us, Arthur.
Oh, me and Bill and Sadie.
You okay, son?
Sure.
We ain't been back for more than a few days.
What do we do, Dutch?
Clearly, we need to leave. It'll take them some time to regroup. Mr. Pearson, Miss Grimshaw, start packing up. Javier, you and Bill, get out of here. Go scare off any scum still loitering about. We need a couple of days. Now, please, gentlemen.
Sure. What next, Dutch?
We just need some time. I need some time. Now, we can't go east, because then we'll be in the ocean, so we're going to have to go north, I guess. I just need somebody to buy me some goddamn time, one of you.
You'll figure it out, boss. You always do.
What are you going to do about John, Dutch?
John?
He's in jail.
Well, we'll get him. Abigail, just not yet.
There's talk of hanging him.
It's not going to come to that.
Dutch!
Not now, Mesa. Not now.
I'm begging you to. They're going to hang him. It'll break my... the boy's heart. Please, do something.
We will. Okay. I'm going to go figure out how we rescue this bastard.
Now?
Yes, now. Meet me at Doyle's Tavern on Million Avenue.
Okay. My lord, what a goddamn mess. Everything. Not sure what happens next. Whole thing has been hard on all of us. Most of all on Dutch, who seems half crazed by all we've gone through.